Stand clear of the closing doors, please.
Put that bottle of bleach down. We got another episode of Quake right here and right now. This is a certified hood classic. So in the last episode, I was talking about how Quake was a very influential game. And I didn't just pull that out of my ass. I did find a chart showing all the different games that were inspired by Quake. So I'm going to put that on screen right now. Hooah! So yeah, I'm assuming you paused to take a look at that. Lots of good stuff on there. Did you notice they had a Daikatana? That one famous game made by that dickhead who originally worked on Quake and then left because he thought that he could make a better game all on his own? I think that was John Romero. I'll just make my own Quake, you'll all see. And then he tried and it sucked. Remember how angry everybody was over that game? Daikatana, because the marketing campaign insulted gamers. And that was like the first incident of gamer rage. I mean, nowadays you see it all the time, but back then that was quite rare. People were pissed off about that magazine ad because it said John Romero is about to make you his bitch, and people were saying like, what? He can't say that to me? I'm a gamer. My mom says I'm a special little boy. Anyone who got angry at that's a fucking wuss. But why are we having this conversation in 2021? Talking about some shit that happened a quarter of a century ago? Now is not the time to hold such conversations. That time has passed. We need hot takes for the present day. Such as... I think that free-to-play games are predatory in terms of their monetization practices. That's not too much of a hot take, though. I think most people would agree with that. Oh, look at this. We got a laser cannon. What's that meme? I'm a firing my laser. Blah. That sounded like a car door. Is this take gonna be ruined as well? Son of a bitch, I'm just never gonna get this episode done. Let's just keep going. So anyway, yeah, I was talking about the I'm a firing my laser, and there was the laser collection back in the day. Those were funny. Oh my god, I can't wait to eat this watermelon. I just hope that mysterious thing doesn't happen. Oh well. Long-time viewers of this channel are probably amused by that, because that's like the fifth time I've brought that particular clip up. There's a force field to our left. I don't know how to get past it, so I guess we'll just go do something else. Branching paths. Very futuristic. Anyway, speaking of Futurama, you know, I've been meaning to watch the Futurama finale since it happened like 8 years ago, and I just haven't gotten around to it. I'm quite the procrastinator, evidently. Years go by and things don't get done. Speaking of procrastinators, I was about to say I'm the John Kay of the gaming world, but then I remembered the stuff that he did, and perhaps that's not the comparison that should be made. Okay, there's an engine revving outside. I don't know what that's about. Hope somebody's not and trying to intimidate me, just pull into my driveway and rev the engine a bunch. Try and put a stop to my let's plays. Hey yo, he making let's plays up there. We'll show him a thing or two and just lay on the gas. It's like this video I saw once where, fuck it, too hard to explain. So there's the Quake logo, by the way. The developers put the symbol from the box art right in the game. They're very aware of what makes Quake iconic. Good branding, if there ever was. Top quality stuff. So since the modding scene for Quake is so huge, Here's a question for you. Has anyone ever made a Channel Awesome themed Quake mod where the premise is that Doug Walker has finally had enough and that he's just going to take it out on all of his artistic Channel Awesome buddies like Angry Joe and Linkara and Jew Wario? I probably shouldn't have said Linkara. I think he's actually autistic. That's going to get me in trouble someday. Oh well, it's not like anybody watches this. But anyway, yeah, somebody should make a Channel Awesome Quake mod. They could have like a bunch of different characters, like Santa Christ and the female Channel Awesome lady whose name I can't remember. Or Malcolm. Yeah, that was another one. They could have Malcolm as a playable character. Yeah, Channel Awesome in Quake. And Doug Walker could make that horrible high-pitched shriek that he does sometimes. I'm not going to try to imitate it here in mixed company with people listening to me. They're going to kick in the door and think, "What's he screaming about? What's wrong?" But yeah, you know what it is. You know how it is, as the black people say. No, don't say that. Oh dear. So, I was listening to the soundtrack of a Jet Set Radio Future the other day. You know the one. And to my surprise, you know that one famous song on the track? It was the rap song about the dude who works in the grocery store. I think it was just called, like, Girl in Aisle 10 or something like that. Anyway, apparently a white boy sings that. I couldn't believe it. I looked up the music video and I was like, "Whoa, there's a whitey." Didn't expect that. You learn something new every day. Jet Set Radio Future. Put it on backwards compatibility, you cowards. I want to play my cel-shaded discount Tony Hawk clone with fantastic musical choices. And I want it now. I will gladly pay money for that. But that's not going to happen. Sega doesn't do anything cool anymore. Modern Sega sucks. Oh dear. So what's John Romero of Quake fame doing these days anyway? Is he even still alive? I don't even know. I don't know nothing about anything. I don't follow the gamer news. I mean, he's probably still alive. Why wouldn't he be? Wasn't that old. Quake didn't come out that long ago. So here's some Quake trivia for all you Quake enthusiasts out there. During the early stages of Quake's development, it was going to be a very different game. They didn't really have a concrete idea of what they wanted, and one suggestion was to have a third-person fighting segments in the style of Virtua Fighter, because Virtua Fighter was a new thing at the time. This was back when people respected Sega and actually tried to copy their ideas. It's a long time ago, obviously. If anybody tried to look for Sega for inspiration for the gaming company now, people just say, "What the hell is wrong with you?" Oh, Sega, you used to be cool. So, yeah. I don't think we're gonna... Yep, there you go. A Soulsborne character came to put an end to whatever this was. I guess he wasn't a fan of the channel. He had to run up and murder me in order to put a stop to this Let's Play. And honestly, I don't blame him.